Hannibal, so it's the day of the Yoshi for now.
All right. Takion versus Tamim. Here we go. Game one starting on Town and City.
All right, very beautiful tag coming out from Tamim. Dyrat is cool.
Yeah. I was told, you know, most likely that is Tamim considered the best Bayo in this game?
It's a weird thing where right now he would be, but I feel like day one, Tooth Bayo? I don't know, man.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. You really don't know this case.
Yeah, I'd say it's either Tamim or it's potentially Tooth.
Obviously, there's less people in general, but hold on a second, because Takion just took Canada's first stock.
That's the thing about Pichu. You can't even, like, look away from the screen for 1 second. If you let Pichu just get some crazy combo, it's going to be a stock in, like, 10 seconds or less.
Wow. Takion showing no fear right now.
Yeah, getting all these grab combos will work. However, let's see if he knows how to SDI out of these combos.
It's actually like way more hype when Bayonetta's managed to land that off the top combo. It's a lot harder to execute.
That's true, and they always have to go for the fair. Oh
my gosh!
Tacky on two stocks off of Tamim in less than a minute.
Take notes, Pichu players, because right now, this man is showing how to be an offensive Pichu. Great landform in the forward smash. And Tamim's trying to power or perfect shield all of these Thunderbolts, but not really getting in.
How did that back here miss? But let's see what we can do here. Again, it looks like Takion might be able to know how to SDI out of these combos because he got hit by that side B, and he immediately went too low to get followed up after anything.
And Bayo still showing that with a good forward throw and a very light character that will kill at 130.
And there goes the grab.
Missed a second up air. Almost got his combo stolen. We're getting control.
Ooh, that was random. But it worked.
Pichu's so cute.
Yeah, very cute.
So adorable.
Happy to see Pichu instead of Pikachu, you know, honestly.
Yeah.
Let's see. F-Smash? Yeah. Oh, goodness. Oh,
wow,
goodness.
Double dare?
What is he doing?
Another one. Okay.
Flashy.
Only two hits there. Tamim, wait, getting a hit. This might. Great air dodge from Takion.
Wow, he's getting out of these combos right now.
Might go for low back air or low dare.
Ooh, okay.
Little air dodge. All right, which time only working for a little bit here.
Oh wow.
The boot, but it's not going to kill.
An actual down smash might have a little more range than the up smash. Maybe that's why he went for it. Last time he went for the up smash, and he missed it. He got punished. And down B? No.
We're going to find out really quick. Takion, okay. He's at 145, though. At this point, any tilt will kill, and that will definitely kill. Ass back air. Taking the first game, Takion, representing Jacksonville.
Ooh, looking really rough right now for Tamim. That was a clean win. Was that a two-stock?
That was a two-stock.
Yeah, a clean two-stock coming out from Takion. And like you said, best player in a lot of the Smash games from Takion, Florida. I mean, from Jacksonville, Florida.
you know, at this point, let's call it Takion, Florida.
Oh.
Petition to call it Takion. What if his name was actually Jack? That'd be sick, or Jackson.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
But of course, remember, guys, this is loser's bracket. Tamim, potentially on his last match of his entire Frostbite experience here.
He's always been known as a really aggressive Bayonetta. However, with this Bayo, it's a lot harder to be aggressive because you go for that down tilt, you miss it, and you're going to get punished really hard. Or that side B misses, definitely more lag. So let's see what he's able to do this time around with Lilac.
Is this tag really Dyrat?
Yep. Hey, you gotta have the mindset of what you want to do. And this stage is fantastic for Bayo because of the tilts. You could just shoot the bullets and do so much damage. And the bullets are actually better in this game because they combo into each other. In the last game, you get hit by one, you could block. In this game, you get hit by one, it just keeps going.
Going back to the roots. And the ledge here, you know, they fixed most of the ledge issues here, but it's still a wonky ledge. Don't trust this ledge too much.
At all. And so, I mean, currently losing a percent, but might be able to bring it back, especially using the bullets.
Okay. I like that dash tech at the soft fair, drag down.
Is this guy really DIing all this stuff? He got hit by the side B, wasn't able to get... Oh, did you see that up tilt miss?
I did.
All right, I don't know, man. Maybe this character is...
Okay.
Maybe this character isn't that good. that miss.
You know? Nah. Oh, what? Okay, so he parried the... or shielded the bullet that came afterwards. I forgot that Bayonetta has that feature.
Fantastic coming out from Tamim right there. It deciding to roll in, not getting hit by the F smash from Pichu this time.
I almost thought Pichu just standing still could avoid the forward smash because of how short Pichu is.
Yeah.
Wow. That'll definitely kill.
I don't know why it looks funny to see Pichu get punched in the face by a really big fist.
It's like, how did it come to this?
Yeah. All right, pretty safe recovery coming out from Tamim, and I like that. Playing a safe, might as well go for the extra credit damage right there. There we go. That's a combo.
Ooh, 22, but a forward tilt, so effective at killing.
All right, good stuff coming out from Takion. Trying to go for that grab. This is it. safe. Got to run away. You definitely have to run away from Pichu. Don't want him getting those grabs. And you want to try to stay on the platform as much as you can, because those combos coming out from Pichu, especially from the ground, they happen to do a lot of damage.
Upper into back air, hitting a Thunder Jolt. I think he tried to go for the dare there, but didn't quite connect. He gets the grab and back throw. Will it lead to a kill? Okay. Ooh. He hesitated.
All right, and I know, and remember, guys, Pichu can KO very, very early, so this is prime percent, especially with one simple back air.
Or down B.
And there goes that back air, but not enough. Let's watch out for that F smash. He's going to likely go for it. Oh.
Oh, wow. Okay. Tamim actually finding the kills this game.
Down low complete. He keeps rolling behind Pichu and getting the KOs with F smash. So maybe Takeyama needs to watch out for that and realize you can't go for risky KO attacks at the ledge like that. Uh-oh. Bayo. Almost. And he keeps trying to do the bullets at the ledge.
Wow. Oh! It killed to the side, actually, but it was still enough, given that he was at 108%.
That's the crazy thing about that attack. Even if you do happen to not get the actual spike part of it, that could still KO.
Tamim wants the rat to die, but unless he can actually make that prophecy come true, this will be his last stock at Frostbite.
Ooh, okay, got him on a platform. Missed the first two hits of forward air, but doesn't matter.
Ooh! Oh, okay, avoided it.
Yo, this guy's crazy with those side Bs. So random out of nowhere.
Dude, the fact that Pichu can do the side B, hit your shield, then jump away, or even miss, like it's like almost risk-free.
Uh-oh, let's see. Can he get one? A nice downwards DI coming out from Takeyama.
Oh, the Nair, no jab reset. That would have been devastating, but missed it.
Yeah, that could have potentially been a KO. Right here is he's actually pretty much a KO percent, especially due to down B or F smash, 85. Very scary for Tamim.
As close as you can get it. He rolls away.
Oh, my gosh.
Once again.
Oh, that's not a safe spot. Oh, gather there. Here we go.
Up, witch twist out of shield. Almost gonna kill Pichu at 120. Air dodge.
Oh, he went too hard.
I think he's gonna go for a super hard like forward smash read.
You think so?
Yeah.
Oh, right here.
Oh, that would have been it.
Pichu, he might be scared to do it this time though, because he lost last.
Oh, what is? Oh. Oh my gosh.
Is that it?
Oh, he avoids it again. Takeyama, you madman! The back air, and we have a game three. Tamim not breaking a sweat.
Oh my goodness, that was actually quite the struggle for Tamim to get that KO with that backer. Getting all these good reads, playing so well, but once he gets to like 80%, that could be it for a stock.
Alrighty. Man, so many crazy sets so far today.
Not crazy. Even
in bracket yet, this is still pools.
This is still pools, man. Round two pools.
It's big boy pools, but still pools.
Big boy pools, man. It's ultimate pools. It's so scary.
It's like you went from having your floaties and now you're in the deep end or whatever.
Yeah.
So you gotta prove your worth.
Well, round one was shocking me so much. That's how I knew round two would automatically be very hype, like no matter what. But here we go, game number three. This is now Pichu's counterpick stage. Let's see why he picked it. Ooh, here goes the grab. Okay, not able to confirm too much off of it. Tamim is known for trying to go for side B off the ground, but I don't know if that move is as good as it was in the last game or as safe.
Right. A good backer to contest. Wow,
oh,
is that a stock?
It?
No
my
way.
My gosh.
No friggin' way.
Oh my goodness gracious.
Beautiful. What? Such. I mean, you couldn't have picked a better option there.
Yeah, that's true. He got hit at 75%. He was 75% after the down B. You always have to be very careful of Pichu using that down B whenever you're off the stage that early. Let's see what we get.
All right. Well, the question is, obviously, last game, Tamim was able to find these really raw forward smashes, but the tilt of the stage might have helped him in that regard.
Yep.
But now this is a way bigger stage, a lot more open, a lot more room for Pichu to run around, maybe stand on platforms for a bit. It's going to be tricky.
Yep, very tricky. But Pichu being such a small character, really hard for Bayonetta to hit, especially with the back air.
He just has to win a neutral. Oh! I would have actually lost it.
This guy loves to go for double dip down air.
He really does. It's a buy one, get one free.
Yep. Uh-oh, let's watch out for that F smash. I don't see Takeyama going for it too much anymore, but oh, he's searching for something. Here it is.
Oh, can he get the kill? It looks like this will be a kill.
Boom!
What?
Hey! Oh, no.
And what timeline is this where I think that Bayo feels cheated?
Sakurai's
okay, but
laughing.
He got the kill. But he got the yes.
Sakurai's laughing from some secret corner like, hey.
Reggie is laughing from his beach chair. Just like, enjoy Smash Ultimate. Now we're waiting right here.
Oh, looks like he's looking for it again. Last time he was dashing around, he was looking for that F smash. That back air should be able to KO. And there it is. Entire stock ahead. Kentucky on all he needs is one more stock to be able to finish this. And Tamim could be out like in the 100th plus place. Let's see.
Going back in once again.
He's trying so hard.
This is looking grim for Tamim. I think he's giving it all.
What? I guess he might have just SD'd on purpose.
Yo, I'm gonna real here. I don't think Tamim made a mistake.
Is that a joke?
I think he meant to kill himself on purpose.
Oh, I thought that was a pun because his name used to be Mistake.
Yeah.
Oh, it was? Okay.
that was the. No, I'm just gonna. Yeah.
It took me a while to get it. I don't think Tamim made a mistake. All right, that was a good one. I rate that one at like a 10.